Hello everyone, I finished FreeRTOS task API with 3 videos. Then I'll continue with FreeRTOS queue API. Let's start the machine. As I mentioned the FreeRTOS overview video, Queue API used to send data from a task to another task. I'm gonna explain it with drawing. Let's say this is task 1, this is task 2, and there is a buffer that we can arrange its size. Let's say 5 for this example. Task 1 will send a data to buffer, and task 2 can get it from buffer. Then delete the value from buffer. Each data block on queue buffer can be any data type or any size. They can be integer, float, character or string, etc. I start from my FreeRTOS task example because there are already 2 created tasks. I'll add queue library to use it. And let's determine a queue to try its usage. Queue handle t Queue-1. I'm gonna delete printf functions. Then let's create it on task 1. Firstly, let's create a string to store data. We can store a string on it up to 50 character limitation. Then let's create the queue. The first parameter determines character number on queue buffer, and the second parameter is the size of each character on buffer. I've used size of tx buffer, so each block will have 50 character limit. Also, I'm gonna check whether the queue is created successfully or not. Then we're ready to send data to buffer. Let's fill some string to our variable and send it to queue. Thanks to sprintf function, we can fill a string like that. This means tx buffer now has hello world as a value. Then let's send this buffer to queue. xQueueSend. The first parameter of this function, which queue will be used. I'll write our queue. The second parameter is pointer to data, which I would like to send. Let's write it. The last one is blocking time. I don't wanna make any block. Then let's write 0. So this is how to send a data to queue buffer. Let's clone it with different values. Then we send value to queue successfully. Let's go to task 2 to get data from the queue buffer. Firstly, let's create a Rx buffer to store data which will come from queue buffer. And I would like to check the queue buffer constantly, so I'm gonna write getting function on while loop. Let's write read function xQueueReceive. The first parameter is which queue will be checked, as you know from queueSend function. The second one is pointer of receiver buffer. You can also write it with ampersand. And third one is, as you know from send function, blocking time. When we sent a data, we didn't use any blocking time. But let's use it from there because this is an infinite loop, and if we don't use blocking time, some data could miss or overlap. I highly recommend to use a little blocking time when you receive data from queue buffer. Let's add printf function to see which data we get. I'm gonna add if statement with this function, otherwise it's gonna run always this printf function. But I would like to see it when I got data from queue. Also, I would like to use another two functions to learn information about QBuffer. We can see how much data is stored on QBuffer and how many blocks left thanks to this function. Then let's compile it to see how it works. You see, we sent hello world 1 as first, receive function get it first and then get the other values. And I would like to show another useful function, which is send to front. When I use it, you know, we have queue buffer and these values will be written to this buffer within order. However, if we use to front function, this data will be written as first. Let's compile and see results. We sent hello world 3 lastly, but xQueueReceive got it firstly. Lastly, I'll show another function, which is xQueuePeak. As we know, receive function read the first block of xQueueBuffer and delete it, and then read the other value. If I change receive function to peak, it's gonna get data from xQueueBuffer, but it won't delete it. Let's see. You see, the first block isn't deleted and peak function always get same value. This is can be used for different application. It isn't used frequently, but got to know it. That's all I am going to talk about today. Stay motivated and subscribe me. Let's control the controllers together.